Yo, 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 it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in with my boy Bogan Leck out here in New Orleans, man.
You already know.
Yeah, 1,000, man. Now, you got tapped in through that boy Hot Boy. We thug. We raw and uncut. You got tapped in through my nigga Hot Boy Jason.
Yes,
you know what
sir,
I'm saying?
Bob.
Yeah, man. You know, he be doing his little thing out there in H-Town and shit. So, you originally from New Orleans?
Hell yeah, born and raised right here.
No shit. What's out of town we on right now?
Shit, right now we in Chalmette. We about 15 minutes out of actual New Orleans.
Okay, that's what's up. It's the east, west, like west side, like...
I call it south side.
South side.
It's like, maybe like southeast, to be honest.
Okay. Nah, because like, you know, with me, I don't know this shit like that, you know what I'm saying? The areas I've been driving all over this bitch the last 2 days, you know what I'm saying? Just spinning through different hoods, different outskirts, you know what I'm saying? Kenner, here, there, all these places. So I'm trying to figure it out a little bit myself. But
yeah,
man. So tell me what it's like growing up out here in this area, dog.
Shit, for the most part, it's chill. I mean, like, don't get me wrong, just like everywhere they be having bullshit that be going on, but you just stay true to yourself and just do what you want to do. You can make whatever pop.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. Because, like, I hear one thing I'm seeing, bro. Everything's so close. Like, all the wards, this shit is, like, right on top of each other, dog. Like, all the different areas, the sides. It's like, damn, this shit real close. And it's one street, like, because when my boy was just like, man, that hoe really kind of big on the cool, bro. But he was like, I was like, nah, bro, this hoe really ain't, because one street take us from goddamn Harris Casino all the way to the highway that brought us here, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it was a straight shot there, straight shot on that street. So damn, that shit be crazy, man.
They got that shit set up like extra simple. Like shit, you could get the whole way from the motherfucking river over here the whole way to Lake Pontchartrain.
Yeah.
Like just one shot, just
Yeah, for sure. So you came up fucking with music or you know, cause you actually, man, you got your hands in a lot of different shit.
It's only right.
Yeah. You fucking with music and you fucking with skate and apparel and all that shit. So you just grew up in the culture or what?
I mean, I'm going to keep it a buck with you. Like, I started off with the music and then I wound up getting a little job at a studio. I was just working front desk. They was like, why the fuck you don't make music?
Okay.
And I just started right there. Started writing. After that, I was just really timid about that shit at first because I don't know, I didn't think I could do it type shit, but I had a few people that was just like, so do it.
Yeah.
So I just started fucking with that shit, and then, you know, the clothing line just started growing up and up and up, so I just figured, fuck it, I got a platform, I might as well do this shit.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to dip my hands in really every crowd that I can, even though my shit is developed around a niche.
Okay. Yeah. So, would you like punching all this shit, like, which one would you say you mold? Like in dialing, which one you feel like is the most like that you want? I mean, I know you ain't tripping. Whichever one take out first, you gonna go with the flow.
Right.
But which one do you feel like I got more of a passion in? The music or the apparel and the skateboard and all that?
It's really like what type shit. Like, don't get me wrong, I can't go a fucking day without thinking about new music and shit. But then at the same time, I'd be waking up middle of the night. Oh shit, this would be fire on a fucking on a shirt or on some pants.
Okay.
9 yards. So it's just like, I dip and dabble on all of that shit. So it's just like you said, whatever take off first. But I really love it all. I wouldn't do it if I didn't love it. I got passion for that shit.
For sure. That's what's up, man. That's live there. So with you punching and pressing your shit, how you doing? You running your program, dog. What would you say be the hardest part in this shit for you, especially dealing with the business side of it?
Man, I'm gonna keep it a build. Like, down here, it's like real fucked up with like people trying to support the community. Like, my fan base, real shit, is mostly in Australia and Canada.
Yeah.
Down here, I'd be damn near having to give somebody a shirt just to wear it.
Gotcha.
Like, I got people across the fucking country, across the
world,
across the world. Like, literally, that's just like, yo, let me get this, that.
Yeah.
And fuck, like, it's just, down here, it's more or less like, you gotta get out type shit. Like, you don't have to, because, you know, you do have your few certain artists that do, you know, do what they do down here, but, like, they stuck down here.
For sure.
So, I mean, I'm just thinking outside the box with it. They got so many people in this world, I gotta be a few that fuck with me.
For sure. Nah, you got to, bro. That's why I'm out here doing these interviews, though. this shit goes on everywhere, dog. Like, every city is hard to get hometown support. You know, some cities, of course, is going to be better than others.
Right.
It's going to be like that. You know what I'm saying? But in Houston, bro, it's the same motherfucking way, dog. Like, I'm going to tell you like this, bro. I put on this on my Instagram, and I got plenty of rappers that follow me. I mean, I got like 3K above 3,000 followers or whatever, but niggas be tuned in to my page. You feel me? Like, a lot of niggas don't want to follow. I don't give a fuck, though. You know, I'm going to do me. But they know what's going on. They know what I do. Niggas in the game know what I do, bro. I done over 200 interviews. You feel me? I got over 1,500. I got over 1,400 YouTube videos. I'm like 1,480 YouTube videos. I go crazy, dog.
Persistence right there.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about the views. I don't give a fuck about it. I'm dropping whatever. I
get out of there.
Huh?
It's because you want to.
Exactly.
Do it.
This my shit. This what I do. So exactly. I don't fuck around. So, like, I tell you, I put on my IG, hey, man, I'm doing $50 interviews for the rest of the year. From, it was like December 10th. Not one nigga booked the interview with me in Houston. But once shit go up, because I already know, I done already got all the signs I need to know that I'm going up. I'm going to go. But once I go up, niggas is going to try to come back and still get their 50.
Say, I've been fucking with you, yeah.
No, they gonna try to come get their little $50 shit. No, bro. This shit about exposure, bro.
Exactly.
This shit ain't about quality. This shit is about information.
Right.
You telling them, and go and tell them right now, the name of your clothing line and the Instagram for that. Shit,
We the Indigo, WETHEINDIGO.
Yeah, We the Indigo. So my job is to make sure I give you the exposure that to my supporters and my following, that they know where they can get in touch with what you got going on.
Right, and it should be vice versa.
It's the same shit, but even if you ain't spreading this is my job as the motherfucking nigga that's in the streets out here. This street, it's basically like street radio, street internet, street everything, you know what I'm saying? But niggas can't see the vision, you feel me? That's just what it is. So I say that because you brought up the whole vibe of like niggas out here not fucking with it. But overseas is ahead of time.
Yes.
They already see your shit like, okay, this nigga making moves, the clothes looking good, we like what it's standing for. So with this clothing, now you say you got like a whole little team working with you too, huh?
Yeah, fucking right. I got like, right now I believe it's 9 people from literally here to Switzerland.
Okay.
The whole way at the bottom of the fucking United States to Switzerland.
Yeah.
And basically, they all just, they be pushing my shit for me, you know, I hook them up with some clothes and shit, just to make sure they straight, and I make sure they straight, you know, one hand wash the other type shit.
Yeah, stomp down with this shit. Nah, because the thing when they understand, teams win championships, you feel me? Teams win championships, MVP players win games, make highlights, they get on ESPN, you know what I'm saying? But they don't get championships. You gotta have a team, bro. I understand that shit now, more than ever now. Like, you gotta have a team, and really, the leader of the team ain't supposed to be working the hardest. You know what I'm saying? At all times. It's like, you got to find niggas who work as hard as you do with that shit and really believe in it. So, with you doing that and doing the music, bro, would you feel like you just going to come out and be able, what you want to open a store? How you want to do it?
Shit, like, realistically, It would be fucking awesome to have a store.
Yeah.
But that bitch would be like the size of an academy. Because I want my clothes in that bitch. I want scooters in that whole, skateboards.
Okay.
You know, like the whole, that bitch would have a skate park in it too.
Yeah.
Like the vision for that shit would be like beyond the roof.
Yeah.
But like, other than that, I mean, like, everything is web-based right now.
Okay.
You know, I make my shirts when y'all order them.
Yeah.
Boom, I send the bitches out next day.
1,000.
You know?
1,000.
I don't play no games with that shit because I know there's a lot of buffoonery going around.
For sure. You got to do square business. You got to do stand-up real business, man. So let's get into more of the music side, bro. You tapped in with some niggas I know. Musically, you know what I'm saying? What type of work you got out there right now?
Shit, right now I just got a few singles out, but yeah. I do plan on, I'm going to have an album coming out on Libya. That bitch is going to be called Libya.
Yeah.
Probably just going to be called Libya. And then I also got another little tape coming out with Hot Boy Jason. That bitch going to be called Yin Yang Twins.
Yeah.
You could obviously tell why it's called that. Come on, I don't need to put it down. You already picked it up.
Yeah, for sure. So, would you come on with that tape? And then you got the other singles out. You got them on Apple Music and shit like that.
Shit,
or?
I actually plan on having them out there in the next month. That shit gonna be on all streaming platforms. Bet. Right now, I'm just kind of sitting pretty.
Yeah.
Collecting my bread.
They coming out, man. Y'all get ready for them. Tap in. Give them the Instagram one more time. You know, just give them your personal and the other one.
My personal is Boganleck, B-O-G-A-N-L-E-C-K.
Yeah.
And the clothing line / scooter team / bike team / skate team / whatever the fuck you want it to be.
Yeah.
We the Indigo, W-E-T-H-E-I-N-D-I-G-O.
Yeah, 1,000. Also, man, if you could have any artists that you want to work with right now in the game on a track, who would you get on the track with, bro? Any artist in the game?
I ain't gonna lie, yeah. Texas killing it. I either gotta say Lil Tuzi.
Okay.
Or fuck, probably Sauce.
For sure, shout out Sauce, shout out Lil Tuzi too, man. Nigga doing his thing, he hot as fuck right now. And who would you wanna see in your drip, man, in your fashion? If you could put your fashion on anybody in the game, who you wanna see? Okay, I like that nigga got my shit on. He gonna wear it correctly how I want it to be seen.
Type shit. Really, anybody that I be fucking with. You gotta watch who you be around.
Yeah.
Cause real life, they be snakes in the grass all the fucking time.
Yeah.
So I mean, if they got it, they got it. You know, that shit gonna be given. It ain't even gonna be no,
for sure.
Oh, please wear this shit for me. Nah, fuck that. Like, if it ain't no genuine shit, I ain't about to pay you to wear my clothes.
For sure.
Like,
for
if you don't fuck with me on that level, I don't care if you wear my clothes. Cause I know there's 100 other people that will fuck with me on that level.
Bet, for sure. That's 1,000, man. Yeah, y'all tap in. Make sure y'all follow the homie on Instagram. Got more shit coming, more everything, man. 1,000.